I'm not Leonard Maltin, but this is a century of cinema that we offer at the Historic Plaza Theater on the first and third Wednesdays of each month, except December. Americans love to be scared. We seem to be drawn to things that go bump in the night and stuff that frightens us. Let's delve into and explore monsters of the movies. Let's begin with a German silent film from 1922 titled Nosferatu. This film was an unauthorized adaptation of Bram Stoker's 1897 novel, Dracula. A court case followed, and all copies of the film were ordered destroyed, but several prints survived and came to be regarded as an influential masterpiece of cinema. In America, this genre saw the creation of three significant films in the early 1930s. In 1931, Americans had two great choices: the film Frankenstein with Boris Karloff as the monster and Bela Lugosi as Dracula. Nikola Tesla actually built one of the coils in Dr. Frankenstein's laboratory. Mel Brooks reused that lab for his 1974 comedy, Young Frankenstein. Karloff was born William Henry Pratt, an English-born actor whose career spanned 60 years. In 1932, Karloff starred in the movie The Mummy. In 1966, he voiced the Grinch in a television special, which won him a Grammy. He was married six times. I guess it's hard to love an iconic movie monster. Bela Lugosi was a Hungarian-born actor. After appearing in 172 Hungarian productions in Hungary, he moved to silent films in 1917. He acted in several German films before finding his way to New Orleans on his way to New York City. In 1927, he appeared on Broadway as Count Dracula. In 1928, the play moved to the West Coast and Lugosi settled in Hollywood. Despite being a charter member of the Screen Actors Guild, Lugosi was typecast in horror films. He never overcame his thick accent or was able to demand top billing. Lugosi was married five times and active in American cinema for 25 years. In 1956, at age 73, Bela Lugosi died.
Now that you have learned what you have learned, it would be well for you to return to your own country.
I prefer to remain and protect those whom you would destroy.
You are too late. My blood now flows through her veins. She will live through the centuries to come. as I have lived.
Should you escape us, Dracula, we know how to save Miss Mina's soul, if not her life.
If she dies by day, but I shall see that she dies by night.
And I will have Carfax Abbey torn down stone by stone, excavated a mile around. I will find your earth box and drive that stake through your heart.
Come here.
...1933 brought cinema and new kind of scary with King Kong. Rotten Tomatoes ranks this as the greatest horror film of all time. Gene Harlow was originally sought to star opposite Kong, but the part went to Fay Wray in a blonde wig when Harlow wasn't permitted by the studio to join the production. Created on a budget of under $700,000, the box office generated $5.3 million. Was Beauty That Killed the Beast found its way into American slang thanks to this film. A new scary monster emerged in 1941 with the release of The Wolfman, starring Lon Chaney Jr. This film also featured Bela Lugosi, Casablanca's Claude Rains, and Ralph Bellamy. Budget was only $180,000. Chaney reprised his werewolf role in four sequels. An American Werewolf in London was released in 1981, directed by John Landis. Wonder why studios keep making horror films? This movie, with a budget of under $6 million, generated over $62 million at the box office. Simple answer, cheap to make, big return on investment. In 1954, we discovered The Creature from the Black Lagoon. Also in 1954, the first Godzilla film arrived in American theaters. From 1954 through 2021, 32 Godzilla films have been made in Japan and four in America. Poor Godzilla has had to fight more villains than Hulk Hogan. In 1958, portraying a teenager in his first feature film, 28-year-old Steve McQueen starred opposite The Blob. With a $110,000 budget, this horror flick generated $4 million at the box office, mostly from drive-ins that have now become mainstream. American tastes for horror in the 60s were mostly low-budget, drive-in movie fare churned out by directors like Roger Corman, often from books by Edgar Allan Poe and featuring actor Vincent Price. Horror came roaring back in 1973 with William Peter Blatty's The Exorcist. The books have sold over 13 million copies, and all the film prequels and sequels have generated over $660 million at the box office. This story is actually based on a true event. It involved a young boy from Maryland who eventually ended up hospitalized in Cincinnati following his exorcism. Upon his release, the room was sealed forever.
Hello, Reagan. I'm a friend of your mother's. I'd like to help you.
You want to loosen the straps, huh?
I'm afraid you might hurt yourself, Reagan.
I'm not Reagan.
I see. Well, then, let's introduce ourselves. I'm Damien Karras.
And I'm the devil. Now kindly undo these straps.
If you're the devil, why not make the straps disappear?
That's much too vulgar a display of power, Karras.
Where's Reagan?
In here with us.
That success led Steven Spielberg to try his hand at scaring the dickens out of us with release of his 1975 blockbuster, Jaws.
You're gonna need a bigger boat.
On a budget of $9 million, this film returned $472 million and kept millions of us out of the ocean. Director Ridley Scott tried his hand at horror with the release of Alien in 1979, featuring a memorable performance from Sigourney Weaver as Ripley. Seven other Alien-inspired films have followed. In 1987, the horror thriller Predator premiered with Arnold Schwarzenegger and Carl Weathers. These two films generated $200 million. In 1982, The Thing was released and would have done much better had it not been for E.T. George Lucas gave us some scary creatures, including Rancor from Return of the Jedi in 1983. In 2013, creature Otachi appeared in the film Pacific Rim, and audiences turned over $400 million to be scared. Since 1993, the Jurassic Park films have frightened us to the tune of over $1 billion. We do love to be scared and frightened. Be sure to visit the gorgeously restored Historic Plaza Theatre on our 38-foot wide movie screen, digital projection, and a world-class new surround sound system. Visit myplazatheater.com for showtimes and events. The Historic Plaza Theatre is located in beautiful downtown Miamisburg with unlimited free parking, shops to browse, and fabulous nearby dining options. I hope to see you at the Plaza Theater. See you next time.